Hey y'all, it's Monica with M&D Experience, and today is Saturday, January 26, 2013. And as you know, yesterday I bought a new pair of Newton shoes, my first pair of Newton shoes. And I was looking at the box today before I was getting ready to throw it out, and this was in there. And it's just a little pamphlet here, Newton Running. And in it, it says Newton's 10 Laws of Running Better. So I thought I'd read these to y'all, and maybe you can get some good helpful tips for you on how to have maybe better running form or proper, just overall how to run better. Okay, because it was helpful for me. Number one, get a proper fit. Standing with your heels pulled to the back of your Newtons, you should have a thumb's width in front of your longest toe. The ball of your foot should line up over the middle of the red lugs. So I know this is mainly geared toward the Newton shoe, but a lot of this pertains to regular shoes as well, other running shoes other than Newton as well. Number two, insert orthotics if needed. Newtons are not a substitute for custom orthotics. Remove the sock liner to accommodate your custom footbeds for the ultimate ride. Number three, practice good form. Relax, lean slightly forward, and shorten your stride. Your foot will naturally land on your midfoot at a point under your hips. Keep a high cadence and your stride length short. Do not run on your toes. We tried this at the running clinic. We learned how to lean forward and shorten our stride and how to lift our knees a little bit higher in order to run lighter and run a little smoother. And when we tried this, we did it several times. Man, the difference it made, just that little, you know, that little forward motion in your running form, that little change from here to here was just a huge difference. So I agree with that. That was really good. And if you have a chance to attend a running clinic in your area, please do, because I really want to go one more time just to get a better feel for that. You need to look in your area and see what kind of running clinics there are. They're usually free, and this one happened to be free, and I really enjoyed it. Okay, number four, land, lever, lift. Good running technique is as simple as land, lever, lift. Land quietly in an athletic position with each foot strike under your hips. Lever off the front of the lugs and lift your knee. Do not push off or pull back with the toes. So lift your knee to begin a new stride. I'm getting better at the knee part. I don't feel like I land quietly yet. I don't feel like I'm a gazelle when I'm running yet. I still feel every pound on my body landing on my feet. I'm getting better at it. There are days that I feel lighter than normal, but for the most part, I still feel every pound when I'm running. Adapt slowly is number five. Number five, adapt slowly. To adapt to Newton's action-reaction technology, start with short, slow runs, about a mile or so, a couple of times a week for the first 2 weeks. Focus on good form and gradually increase your time and distance as your body feels ready. As with any sport, too much too fast can cause injury, and that is true, because when we first started our running back in July and August, I mean, you can verify this with Theresa, I was doing even more than we were doing together. We would run together, but a lot of times I would end up running even further by myself, and I ended up with an injury to my right thigh, my upper right thigh. So I had to check with my doctor, and she just told me to basically slack off on my running, because I ended up doing like six miles, 7 miles. It was way too early for me to even attempt to do that. But I got addicted so fast, you know, that I wanted to do more and more, and that's not always the best thing to do. Gradually increase it. Okay, number six. Reduce friction. Landing heavy breaking on your heels, bounding on your forefoot, and pushing off too hard with the toes all create friction. Excessive pounding creates more shock to your muscles, tendons, and bones. Land lightly and run smoothly and efficiently. Again, that's just something I'm still trying to learn. I'm getting better at running lighter, but it's still, especially when I get a little bit more tired, you know, as the miles go by, I'm noticing that my feet feel heavier. So I'm still learning, and I think I'll just get better by repetition and always keeping that in my mind to run a little lighter. Number 7, learn from your shoes. Newtons wear like tires. The shoes act like a coach. By studying the friction wear patterns, you can learn how to adjust and improve your running form. Sorry, I got a little tongue twisted there. And that's true. My salesperson yesterday, that was the first thing she did, was look at my older running pair of shoes, my New Balance, and she learned from that. And I've learned from that too. I could tell my right foot was, the soles of my right foot were way more worn down than the soles of my left. So I know I put more weight on my right usually than I do my left. And there was even somewhere on my heels, which indicated that I did have a slight heel strike. And when they did a video of me on the treadmill, they could tell that I had a slight heel strike. So yeah, look at your shoes and how you're running. You'll be able to tell by the wear and tear on your shoes. Number 8, keep them clean. Yeah, this is just mainly a Newton tip. Hand wash with mild soap and air dry. Do not place in direct sunlight. Number 9, they want you to visit Newton Running Store. But number 10 is the most important one. Can you read that? Number 10. Have fun. Definitely have fun. You know that runner's high everybody talks about? It does exist. It is there. If you're not feeling it right now because you're a new, brand new runner, it will get better, I promise. The first part is really hard because your breathing's not regular. Your heart's not used to pumping so much oxygen to your lungs, and but trust me, once you can get that, you know, regulated, oh my gosh, you will see the runner's high in people's faces. When we're doing these the training for our half marathons right now, there's like 400 people in this running group, and every one of them has that bubbly personality, that yay, you can do it, you know, that gusto that you can only get from running. So relax, take it easy, take it slow, and you will get there very soon. But anyway, I thought I would share those tips. Hope that was helpful for you. Talk to you soon. Bye.